Obama initiated the Race to the Top program. Under this program, states will receive federal money for raising school and teaching standards. The main goal of this program is to help students graduate and be ready for college, and to have the necessary skills to outcompete workers in other parts of the world. During his presidency, Obama was able to keep his promises in certain areas. According to PolitiFact.com, he increased research opportunities for college students and protected student borrowers from predatory lending, taxes on loans, and others. However, he didn't have much luck in other areas. He failed to get Congress to increase funding for the Individuals with Disabilities Education Act and to fund the College Credit Initiative. No funding was for the encouragement of AP classes and other college readiness programs were made.
According to the New York Times, Mitt Romney supports a voucher policy which allows students in grades K through 12 to use $25 billion of federal money in order to attend any school, public, private, charter, or online. U.S. News and World Report says that Romney's education plan, known as A Chance for Every Child, is supposed to help young Americans complete higher education by focusing less on four-year college degrees and more on two-year college degrees, occupational certificates, and apprenticeships, so that students are guaranteed jobs after they finish school and therefore be able to pay back their loans. Romney would also like to cut Pell Grants.
Everything that we researched here about Obama and Romney, everything was new to me because it was never spoken about in my school.
Before, I researched Obama and his gay rights and his stance, I didn't know anything about the Don't Ask, Don't Tell law. I didn't even know it was repealed last year. I didn't even know what it was because I wasn't taught these things in school. And, we should learn this because, once we get older and be able to vote and we're able to go into the world, we're not going to know what to vote for.
Romney's education platform, it made me also want to vote, but I still don't know for who. Because it made me realize how much presidents can do for young people and how much they're not doing. For example, in his education platform, he wants to cut Pell Grants and make it harder for poor kids to get Pell Grants, which makes no sense to me because it's already hard for us to go to school, so you want to make it harder.
I wouldn't have actually thought about voting because it didn't really matter to me. My mom didn't vote, so I never really thought of it, but then when I started researching the candidates and their platforms and stuff, some of the stuff that I learned about, how polar opposite they are about what they want for the country, it really made me want to vote because I didn't want some of the platforms to go through for some of the candidates because I started really caring about what the heck's going to happen with the country.